Alrighty, it's 3:51 p.m. This is Monday, February 25th, 2019. Trade deadline's come and gone. 2 o'clock Winnipeg time, Central time, it was over. And let me tell you guys something right now, for those of you who maybe haven't followed it. I was up, well, of course, I was up this morning early, as always, but from 7 a.m. right through to 2 o'clock and beyond, and still watching it. The wife and I have been glued to the TV. And I'll tell you, man, I'm going to tell you guys something right now. Kevin ChevelDICKSoff, what a fucking poontang. That guy's a moron. All right, the only decent thing he did today, and it was about 9:30 this morning. All right, the Winnipeg Jets have acquired from the New York Rangers Kevin Hayes. That's not a bad pickup. If instead of yelling, get off the ice, McLean, we can now yell, get off the ice, Hayes. We gave up Brandon Lemieux, first round pick, and a conditional fourth. I'm fine with getting rid of Lemieux. I still think there should have been more involved in that. The other deals that were made, and they kind of came after the fact. They trickled in after. Here's what happened. After 2 o'clock, I went for a shower, okay? And the wife came in and said, I told her, keep track of what's going on. She came in about 5 minutes after I got in the shower and says, the Jets got Hendricks. And I went, excuse me, baking powder? I can't hear you. I have an ear infection. I said, say that again, please. She says, the Jets got Hendricks. And she's looking at me like, and I went, tell me you're kidding me. No, the Winnipeg Jets picked up again that useless piece of shit, Matt Hendricks, from the Minnesota Wild. Remember when they dumped him last year? Or the whatever, and then he went to Minneapolis. He went to the Wild, and for a 7th-round pick. I mean, what a steal from Minnesota. 7th-round pick. Beautiful. They don't even want Hendricks. They dump his ass. But Winnipeg has to pick up the shit again. While we're at it, why don't we all go out and get Kyle Cockwood again? Nick Antropov. Let's go get fucking Burmistrov again. Like, are you guys fucking retarded? Then they pick up Nathan Beaulieu from Buffalo for a 6th-rounder. Now, again, they needed a D-man. Beaulieu, I could live with. But giving up a 6th-round, that's, again, a basic steal for Buffalo. What has Buffalo got to lose, right? And then the one that just has to cap it off. Now, Nick Petan is gone, and I'm fine with that. But for who we basically gave up, or for who we got back, for what we gave up, it was a joke. Getting rid of Petan to the Toronto Maple Leafs for somebody by the name of Par Lindholm. Who in the fuck is that? I looked this guy up. He's a nobody. Like, are you kidding me, guys? Are you really fucking kidding me? So we got all this garbage on defense. Then we get Hendricks. Like, of all the players that went today and in the past week, are you telling me that's the best you guys can do? Fuck you, motherfucker. And then to top it off, they get this guy, this kid by the name of Bogdan Kislevich from the Panthers for a 7th-round in 2021. Who the fuck is this Kislevich? Who is that? That's the best you can do as well? Fucking serious? Another D-man. Who are these guys? Your defense just got worse, people. You can't see it? Most of getting rid of Nick Petan was a desperate move. I'm fine with him going, but you could have done something more. Don't tell me you couldn't have. Toronto's laughing at you right now. Florida's fucking laughing at you. And the one that does it for me, the Minnesota Wild, not are they just laughing at you, but they're just shaking their head going, dum, 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 dum. Who do the Jets play tomorrow night? Minnesota, here in Winnipeg. Hendricks, you remember, is that useless piece of shit that last year against Nashville in round 2 of the playoffs was always going up to the goaltender doing that stupid shit with the stick. Remember what that idiot Avery used to do, that the shenanigans? Yeah, Mr. fucking penalty. Like, really? Are you, like, seriously, are you kidding me? I don't know. I couldn't believe it. When the Hayes trade happened this morning, we were like, hey, that's not bad. But let me tell you this. The Winnipeg Jets, as an organization, you just got worse. You did. You just got worse. I'm not saying you got worse with Hayes. That's not a bad fill. The other shit is all garbage. It was desperate. They were desperate. You could have gotten, there was a number of guys that were available. Absolutely. You could have got, what was his nuts? Gabranson, I think. You could have had him as a D-man. Oh, what was that other motherfucker's name? Oh, shit. From Columbus. McQuaid. Adam McQuaid. Could have had him. But no, you blew it on that too. Fucking idiots. And then, of course, for those of you who don't know this, Mark Stone went to Vegas, and they gave up pretty much nothing. So again, the Jets totally fucking missed the plane and the bus and the boat on, and everything on this. You missed out on Duchesne. You missed out on DeZingle. You missed out on Stone. Wade Simmons went to Nashville. You fucking fucked that up too. 0 for 4, assholes. That's the best the Winnipeg Jets could do today. And I'll tell you why. If you think for 1 second that they were looking to improve, they did everything they could to get worse this way. Because after last year's street party and the fact that where they went to the conference final was not supposed to happen. And they made sure they downgraded. That way they make sure it won't happen again. All right? They just got worse. To me, they're looking to tank, as you want my fucking honest opinion. I have no respect for ChevelDICKSoff. I've never liked him. He's a shitty general manager. Anybody who is basically happy with the general outcome of this today, you then need your head examined, because we didn't get better. We got worse. You got nothing. You've got absolutely nothing today. Don't tell me for 1 second. And then there's people who will say, well, what would you have suggested? It's not up for me to suggest. I mean, if you got a general manager who can't do it, then you shouldn't be general manager. All these other guys, all these other teams are doing it. And I know people are going to say guys like Simmons and Stone and da-da-da-da. We need a defense at this point. Yes, you're right. We needed the center, which we got. But the defense, again, they didn't say we needed good players. They just said we needed players. So they went and did that. They got players. They're not good. Fuck, they're garbage. So tomorrow night, like I said, and the one thing that if they really wanted to do something, they would have just done everything they could to get rid of Eric Comrie as a minor deal move. They could have done, I mean, but again, they won't do that. They won't do that. I would like to have seen Sherratt move. He's fucking garbage. What's going to happen, though, when Byfuglien comes back, which he will, who's going to sit? Well, one of them is going to be the odd man out. So, they're all nobodies. Hayes is going to be a rental. Come July 1, he's out of here. So there you go. You know, I mean, this the Jets had a great chance to pick up some absolutely beautiful players today. They missed every fucking mode of transportation today. The plane, the bus. They missed the fucking. They couldn't even get there by ocean. You know what I'm saying? They couldn't swim to save their lives. So they fucked up. And I was very disappointed. Like I said, I was hoping for Wayne Simmons. I really thought maybe that'd be a nice little punch on the club. I thought maybe Mark Stone. But there was never truly, you know as well as I do, let's just call a spade, there was no intentions to get any of these big name players. They were not, we're looking at, no, they weren't looking, they didn't care. They don't want them. Kevin ChevelDICKSoff does, and the brass, True North, they do not want a repeat of last year. They'd rather see them go out in the first round. That way it's done. And they don't have to pay for anything. It's all over. And I'm telling you this. Anything, and this is the honest truth, anything less than a Stanley Cup win this season, it's a fail. Because the only thing, if they're going to get better than last year, they have to go to the Cup Final. And they have to win it. But then again, that there is, they went to the Cup Final. Then they get better. But no one said they had to win it, right? So you got to watch with anything Winnipeg. They'll play these little mind games and shit. So they have to go to the Cup and they have to win the Cup. That's it. If you don't do it, it's all for naught. And then I think it's time to start making changes. And I mean changes like, you know what? I'm not going to get into that. We'll get into that when the time is right. Anyway, in closing, today's trade deadline was not a success for Winnipeg as far as I'm concerned. I thought after Hayes, I thought they did pretty good there. Who they gave up, Lemieux and a couple picks, who cares? I'm surprised, honestly, I'm very surprised that Niku didn't go, Roslovic didn't go. Maybe that's good. Other than that, It is what it is. I just want to see. I'm getting another text here. I want to see something here. Why is... I'm just getting that... Never mind. Sorry, I'm kind of talking to the person I'm talking to here. The street. That's him, right there. Sorry, I'm just talking to myself, just about... Okay, that's good. Anyway, that's that. We're going to leave it at that. It was a fail. They got shit for defense. The defense just got worse, ladies and gentlemen, please. And it is what it is, and we'll see what happens here going forward. Hopefully the Jets get somewhere. Like I said, tomorrow night, Minnesota's here to take on the Wild, and then that's it for February. As to the Manitoba Moose, there was nothing done today, really, that's going to, that would, if someone was sent down, that's going to help them out. So I think it's a washout season for the Moose. I think even their own management's given up on them. Well, maybe the Winnipeg Ice next year. We can watch a failing team get even worse next year. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. There's your Kevin Chevel day off. On a scale of 1 to 10, there is no minus. So I can't put it to that grade. But honestly, I'd say other than if it was just the haze, I'd say it was about a B+. If it wasn't for that, it would be an F. But overall, because of that, those other three deals, it has to be about a C-, maybe a D. So, yeah, way to go. And if you think any different and you think this is good, time to get your head examined.